On the Crime Watch tonight, a murder in America's last hometown. Police say that a 46-year-old PG resident and Alice L. High School teacher was found stabbed to death at her home on 17 Mile Drive. Action News reporter Stephanie Trong has been following the investigation. She's got the story live from our Salinas newsroom.
Dan, she was killed by the man who dated her daughter, who fathered her two grandchildren. A close friend of the victims tells us she was shocked by the news of the murder, but not surprised by who had done it.
Department of Justice investigators searched this 17-mile drive home in Pacific Grove all day Monday. This is where 46-year-old Judith Salazar was found stabbed to death. Police discovered her body Sunday night after a cab driver called them. He had just dropped off a 26-year-old Seaside man who never came back out.
As they went around to the side of the residence to look through the window to see if they could locate someone, that's when they saw the blood-splattered wall.
Officers forced their way in. That's when they saw Salazar on the ground. She had bled to death after a vicious stabbing.
The suspect, 26 years old, was lying near to her and still breathing. He was cut fairly severely.
That 26-year-old was Sunny Nguyen. He shares two children with Salazar's daughter, an 8-month-old baby boy and 2-year-old girl. Both were there during the murder, in a different room and thankfully unharmed.
It's very sad and just shocking.
Jennifer Westerbeck was not only Salazar's close friend, she was a co-worker at Alice L. High School in Salinas, where Salazar taught special education.
Judith would go to work every day and be there for these special ed kids like nobody I've ever known.
Investigators are staying tight-lipped about what could have motivated Nguyen to murder the grandmother and caretaker of his two young kids. But Westerbeck describes him as unstable. She says he would incessantly call the cell phone Salazar shared with her daughter every few minutes throughout midnight hours.
Because he felt, I would say, probably insecure, he would harass. He would harass Judith and he would harass her daughter, even though they didn't keep him out of their lives.
In fact, Nguyen had celebrated an early Thanksgiving with the victim and her family just the day before the Sunday night killing.
And of course, many questions remain, and I should stress again, about this man who's accused of killing Judith Salazar. We also did learn today that police had been called to Salazar's home at least one time in the last 6 months, although it's unclear if Nguyen was there at the time or connected to that call. As for the mother and the victim's daughter, she was not home at the time of the murder because she does work nights at a local bar, but she has been reunited with her two young kids. Dan.
All right. Thanks very much. Appreciate it, Stephanie. Sunny Nguyen had surgery this morning. He's in a San Jose hospital in police custody, charged with Salazar's murder. He'll be moved to Monterey County Jail as soon as he recovers.